Millions more Californians are eligible to get their vaccines next week, but there won't be enough shots perhaps to go around. The reason, supply issues with one of them, the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. Thanks for joining us. This is a nightly check-in on a Friday. I'm Mark Mullen.
I'm glad I got Johnson & Johnson. I'm glad it's behind me, and hopefully life will start. We can all start living again.
People who were at the Operation Collaboration pop-up site in Carlsbad today got the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, and they got them just in time. In the last week, 574,000 Johnson & Johnson doses were allocated to California. But starting next week, that number will plummet to 67,000, an 88% drop.
We still have Johnson & Johnson supply up until early next week. We'll still see what happens after that, but we know that the counties continue to make us a priority, and we're very excited to continue delivering that.
Firefighters manning Operation Collaboration will keep giving shots with or without the Johnson & Johnson doses. They'll simply switch to whatever vaccine is available, Moderna or Pfizer. The shortage comes on the same week that all Californians over the age of 16 become eligible for shots. And just as we start to see the light at the end of the COVID-19 tunnel, some medical experts are saying that a new health crisis is emerging in some cases. Oxford researchers found as many as 1 in 3 people infected with COVID-19 were later diagnosed with at least one neurological or psychiatric disorder. The study looked at health records from more than 230,000 COVID-19 patients in the U.S. It found 1 in every 3 COVID patients developed at least one neurological or psychiatric disorder in the 6 months after becoming sick. The most common diagnosis, anxiety and mood disorders.
A lot of these patients who suffer from long COVID or past do have psychiatric or neurologic problems, and those symptoms are some of the most common symptoms that we hear about.
Scientists also found that the more people get sick with COVID-19, the more likely they are to develop mental health complications. Vaccine maker Pfizer is asking the FDA to allow 12 to 15-year-olds to get the vaccine. Currently, only those 16 and up can get vaccinated. The drug company said that recent clinical trials they conducted show 100% effectiveness in adolescents. By expanding the age range, Pfizer says it lessens the overall risk of infection for those with underlying health conditions and the elderly. The FDA's review process will likely last a few weeks. Some popular hiking spots in Mission Trails Regional Park will have to close temporarily because of a major project underway. The San Diego County Water Authority is currently building a 5 million gallon underground water tank there. It is a new resource that will help the agency store water year round. The tank is the equivalent to approximately 7 Olympic sized swimming pools.
We're excited about getting this done and getting it filled back in and making sure that no one even knows we're here.
The Water Authority has posted trail detour signs to keep you away and keep you safe. We have a map on NBC7.com so you can see exactly where the construction is, and you know exactly where not to go. Just search Mission Trails on the website. The world is mourning the passing of 99-year-old Prince Philip, the dutiful husband to Queen Elizabeth II for 7 decades. Prince Philip died this morning at Windsor Castle. Millions of people around the world are offering their condolences to the royal family, including President Biden.
He was a heck of a guy. His lifetime of service to the United Kingdom and the whole Commonwealth was visible to everybody for a long, long time.
The funeral will take place inside St. George's Chapel, a much smaller chapel inside the castle grounds. Loved ones in hip-hop music fans worldwide are mourning the death of rap legend DMX. He was just 50 years old. The rapper, whose birth name is Earl Simmons, was hospitalized last week following a heart attack. He's been on life support since. An autopsy will be conducted to determine his exact cause of death. DMX made his rap debut in the 90s and is a 3-time Grammy nominee. DMX also acted in a number of movies, including Belly, Romeo Must Die, and Exit Wounds. Before we sign off here, these are your current temperatures. Dagmar has an extended forecast over at the weather section, which is located on the main menu of our Roku and Apple TV app. It's going to do it for our nightly check-in. I'm Mark Mullen. Have a great weekend.